Hello and welcome to Snakemaster. We have been getting a lot of positive feedback from our viewers. We are very happy that you are enjoying our trysts with the wild. Please don't forget that it's your love and support that keeps us going. I was relaxing at home when I got a call from Rani in Pathanamthitta. The call was from an officer in the Rani division, Mr. Gopi, who is also a good friend. They had found a rare guest and they were going to release him in the forest. I told him to keep it for just a little longer because our viewers have never had a chance to meet such a guest before, and I hurried here to catch him on our show. Our guest today is probably not what you are expecting. We may have heard of it, but I am sure none of us have seen it. It is the Indian pangolin, one of the most reclusive creatures of the wild, also perhaps the most hunted. We are lucky to have found this one because it's very, very difficult to see a pangolin. It's also called an anteater. We often read in newspapers about poaching and trafficking of the pangolins. The Indian pangolin is a critically endangered species. The Indian Forest Act forbids its trade. Keeping it as a pet is a punishable offense. It is a crime to kill a pangolin. Officers of the Rani Forest Division are here with us. They are saying the pangolin is hunted for its scaly shell, which is much in demand. There is a thriving illicit market for it. We hope through this show we can educate people about the need to conserve this endangered species. Many such rare animals are facing the threat of extinction. Let's show them a bit of empathy. There are tough laws for their protection, but those who poach and smuggle them sometimes manage to escape the dragnet. Poaching and trading of pangolin is a non-bailable offense, which can earn up to 7 years in prison and a fine. Time for us to meet our guest. We have him in our vehicle. These officers found this pangolin at a place called Ariada in Tiruvalla. The pangolin is a harmless creature. Our guest here is a male. He's about 7 years old. As long as he is in their custody, these officers have to guard him 24/7. If he gets stolen or killed on their watch, they will be held accountable. They are going to unlock the cage and let him out so that our viewers can have a good look at him. As you can see, he has curled into a ball. This is a self-defense mechanism against predators. He has scales on his body. The scales are hard but smooth. It's called an anteater because it feeds on ants and termites. My advice to everyone is that if you live near the forest and if you were to see a pangolin, just let it be. He will wander off into the wilderness on his own. Just watch what he is doing without disturbing him. Let's now set him down and see how he moves. I am holding him by his tail. His body is very firm and sturdy. He has tucked his arms tightly inside his curled up body. Predators such as tigers and leopards attack the pangolin. The tiger sinks its claws into its body. Once the tiger has its claws in, the pangolin is at the tiger's mercy. He has no claws on his hind limbs, but he does have long claws on its forelimbs. People living in the forest eat the pangolin. They make curries with its flesh. In ancient texts, there are references to kings using its scaly skin to make armors. The pangolin is rarely seen in Kerala. Our officers in Rani say that so far they have seen fewer than 10 pangolins. They are usually seen in the deep forests, in bushes and under natural rock clusters. Pangolin is a mammal that belongs to the Pholidota order. Its number are dwindling rapidly. They are found in the tropical regions of Africa and Asia. The name pangolin is derived from the Malay word penguling, which means something that rolls up. Its most striking feature are the hard plate-like keratin scales that cover its entire body. Keratin is the same protein that make up the nails and hair of animals and humans. These armored scales are a protective shell. The scales of baby pangolins are soft and delicate, but they become tougher as they mature. To escape from predators, the pangolin rolls up into a tight ball, burying its head under its tail. Its scales act as its armored shield. Pangolins have glands that emit strong, foul-smelling secretions. The limbs of pangolins are short and stubby, but they have strong, sharp claws. These claws help them to dig out and tear apart nests of ants and termite mounds and to climb trees. Pangolins are usually 30 to 100 centimeters long. Female pangolins are smaller. Pangolins have long tongues that reach up almost to their ribs. Their tongues are not attached to their hyoid bone, which makes it easier for them to catch insects. A fully mature pangolin can extend its tongue up to 40 centimeters. Pangolins have no teeth and therefore they cannot chew. A sticky saliva coats their tongue. This makes it easy for it to capture insects. The pangolin's gestation period is 120 to 180 days. African pangolins give birth to a single offspring at a time, while Asiatic species have up to 3 offsprings at a time. At birth, they weigh 80 to 450 grams. Pangolins are chiefly nocturnal creatures and hunt for insects at night. We can't leave him here. Let's take him into the woods and free him there.